So, you are thinking to change from your Micro Four Thirds noisy camera to a Fujifilm camera. You want better noise, better color, better pictures and better video quality. Let's find out if you will get better image quality and better video quality on a Fujifilm camera. Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and I'm a heavy Fujifilm user but also a heavy Micro Four Thirds user. And in this video I want to talk about my experience with Micro Four Thirds cameras and also with Fujifilm cameras. I have at least 2-3 years with a Micro Four Thirds camera experience and I've bought my first Fujifilm camera after using Micro Four Thirds cameras for 3 years and I've bought it because I wasn't satisfied with the noise and with the image quality. But I decided not to sell my Micro Four Thirds camera because I was thinking, what if I will miss this camera? And I must tell you, I'm missing the Micro Four Thirds format and I want to tell you why you should think twice if you want to go with a Fujifilm camera. And in this video I also want to show you how you can bypass the noise problems, the color problems that you have with your Micro Four Thirds camera. So let's talk about this. So please subscribe to my channel and share my video with your friends if you like it. So let's get to the subject. As you can see, I have in my hand a Lumix GX9 camera and the brand new OM system Olympus Zuiko lens, the 20mm f1.4 that I've just bought it. And I bought it and I really really love it. I will talk about this lens in a future video, so be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell when this review will come out. So why I've bought a new Micro Four Thirds lens on my Micro Four Thirds system? Well, I found some interesting differences and interesting advantages and disadvantages as I've used also the Micro Four Thirds system and also the Fujifilm system. So, it is important to note that I've used these systems for street photography, for landscape photography, for nature photography and for family pictures. And what I really didn't like at Micro Four Thirds, it was the inability to take good pictures indoors. I really hate that. So, this was my biggest problem. When I was in an interior with low light, I really felt I didn't have good image quality. It's not just about the noise, it's also about the rendition of the faces and the color rendition and all that stuff that it's important to get a good picture. So when you have low light and you don't have enough light, a Micro Four Thirds sensor, it will feel that it is not sufficient. It is not able to gather sufficient light to give you good details and good subject to background separation. So this was a big problem for me. So I decided to buy Fujifilm and I was very happy with Fujifilm. But what I discovered it is that I've missed the image in-body stabilization of a Micro Four Thirds camera. So even if I was able to get better image quality, I was forced to raise the shutter speed. So I was forced to raise my ISO. So the snapping that I was doing with my Micro Four Thirds camera wasn't possible with Fujifilm. So I started to see some problems here. And this is what drive me to look again more closely to the Micro Four Thirds system. So as the year passed by, I've bought my Fujifilm X-Pro 3 and all kinds of Fujifilm lenses. And also I've started to find out that my system, it is bigger, even if at some lenses, at some focal lenses, you have the same volume, the same weight. But as you want to have different focal lenses in your system, you will have a bigger and a heavier system on Fujifilm. So I was winning something and I was losing something. I was losing image body stabilization, I was losing the weight advantages and the volume advantages. But something happened. A year ago, Olympus launched this small pro zoom. This is the 20 to 45 f4 pro zoom. It has an amazing optical quality. As it was launched, I bought it and I've used it. I was very, very impressed. For street photography, I was able to get very good images, very contrasty images, very sharp images, images with good resolution. So this little zoom, it has the quality of the 12 to 100 zoom F4 Pro that I have it and I've sold it to buy this and to get my kit smaller. So I was thinking, okay, now Micro Four Thirds, it is becoming smaller and with the Pro lenses, I get good image quality. I really get good image quality. So the only problem that I needed to solve, it is how can I also get an acceptable, a sufficient depth of field and sufficient light with this old sensor. How can I get this? And OM System just launched the 20mm f1.4 lens. So I've decided to buy it. And I'm really amazed by what I get with this lens. So at f1.4, I can use almost all the time this camera at ISO 200-400 and I can go at a maximum of 1600 ISO indoors, having my subject separated, having my subject isolated, having my subject freezed because I can have a good shutter speed, and also having that feather bokeh, having an optimized lens, a small lens with good resolution at f1.4. This is crazy. This is really crazy. If Micro Four Thirds will give us a backside illuminated sensor that will resolve the noise problem and that will give us more texture and better dynamic range, I don't know, with Olympus Pro lenses and with Lumix Pro lenses, with good optical lenses, you'll get good image quality. Let me tell you now what you will get on a Fujifilm system. Well, you will get Fujifilm colors, you'll get better texture, better dynamic range, better good looking straight from the camera files. Yes, you will get that. Also, you'll get the ergonomics of a Fujifilm camera, better low light performance, but not as much as you can imagine. Now, if you want better low light performance, use an f1.4 lens. You'll get the optics of a Fujifilm camera. The majority of the Fujifilm lenses are good lenses, are optically very good lenses. So I don't have this on a Micro Four Thirds camera. I feel that the non-pro grade lenses aren't so good as the normal lenses that you have on a Fujifilm camera. Also, yes, on this system, you have some lenses that aren't so optically good, but having a backside illuminated sensor, an APS-C sensor, this sensor, it is helping the lens. So yes, you will get maybe 20-30% straight out of the camera better results. But also this depends on what you are doing, what style of photography, what you are doing. If you want to do landscape photography and you need zooms, I can tell you that personally I really like the Micro Four Thirds zooms, small, easy, very versatile. Let me tell you now what you will miss on a Fujifilm camera. You will miss the IBIS. Yes, you have IBIS on X-T4, but it is not as good as on Olympus cameras. And that IBIS, it is really something. That IBIS will really offer you the chance to do pictures that you can't do with a Fujifilm camera or with another APS-C system. You can do all kinds of long exposure pictures with that IBIS. I was able to do long exposure pictures by hand with 12-100 f4 Pro Zoom from Olympus with JX9, hand holding at 70 millimeters focal length on this camera. So this means 140 focal length field of view on a full frame camera. I can't do this with Fujifilm. I can't do this with Sony cameras. So this IBIS that you have on a Micro Four Thirds system, it is something that will really offer you the chance to do some unique pictures that you can't do on other system. And this is something that I'm missing. I love that IBIS. I really love it. At first I thought I don't need it. It's a gimmick. I need better image quality. I need a better ISO. I need better noise to ratio signal. But no, I feel I need it now because not having it, not being able to using it and being forced to raise the ISO and being forced to raise the shutter speed at such high values, I really miss the IBIS. With this good IBIS that you have on a Micro Four Thirds camera, you can do night photography at 1/60 by hand. I can't do this with Fujifilm. And you can be fast. You can be fast. You don't have to stay with the camera. You don't have to have a very steady hand. Just take the camera, point it, shoot and go. This is huge again. I can't do this with Fujifilm and I miss that. I really miss that. So big factor to have in mind. You can't shoot at night with this camera at 1/60 being fast. You can do it, but you must be slow. And I like to be fast. I like to act fast. I see a subject. I like to be fast. I like to go there, take the shot and move on. So I can't do this with this camera. Only if I raise the shutter speed at 1/1500 of a second and raise the ISO to 1280. So What I win? I win nothing in street photography. Also, if you are liking to do landscape photography and all kinds of photography, you will miss the weight factor. An Olympus system or a Lumix system, a Micro Four Thirds system can be really smaller than a Fujifilm or a full frame system. So I was able to carry in my bag three lenses, the 45mm f1.4, the 25mm f1.8, the 20mm f1.4, and so on in a very, very small bag. So, and also this zoom if I need it. So the overall Micro Four Thirds system, it is really smaller. You can have more lenses with you and you can do a lot of different photography styles with a Micro Four Thirds system. So if you like that, you will miss these options. Also, on Fujifilm, you will not have a small 50mm equivalent lens. This is a 35mm f2 lens. It is a beautiful lens. It is a more contrasty and a more and has better resolution than the 25mm f1.8 Olympus lens, but it is a 53mm lens, so it is a little tighter and I feel it. I don't like it. I want a 50mm field of view. I don't like to go tighter and I don't have this option on Fujifilm. Yes, I can buy the 33mm f1.4 from Viltrox or from Fujifilm, but they are bigger. So, where I am. Also, you will miss the 4/3 format sensor. A 2 or 3 aspect ratio of a Fujifilm camera, it is not such a tall sensor. So, you will feel that you will need to raise more the camera, you will need to maneuver the camera in a different way to get the shots that you are used to get when you are using a Micro Four Thirds camera. So this taller sensor, this squared sensor, for me, for street photography especially, but also for documentary work and for landscape photography, I really like it more than a 2 or 3 aspect ratio sensor. Also, the Fujifilm medium format is a 4x3, but it is a big camera system. And at the pixel level, I don't know if you will like the Fujifilm files. If you are a pixel peeper, when you will look at a Fujifilm X-Trans file, you will feel that it is something off from what you are used to it when you are looking at a Sony file or when you are looking at an Olympus or a Lumix file. They are rendering differently. It is something that you must get used to it. Also, you will miss the super zooms from Olympus and Lumix and their very overall image quality regarding the pro lenses. On Fujifilm, you will not have that image quality. The zooms are good, but they are bigger. And I don't know. This small zoom, it's amazing. I really love it. Really love it. The 12-100, amazing F4 Pro zoom. Amazing. With optical stabilization on it, it is amazing. You will not have such good lenses on a Fujifilm camera or on another system. So think about the lenses. Think about the lenses. Before trying to get to Fujifilm, look at the lenses, look at the zooms, look at the primes, think of what you are using and think very well of your style of shooting. If you know what you are doing, you can really obtain good image quality, as I will show you a little bit later. Now I want to talk about videography. On Fujifilm, you don't have good lenses for videography. Yes, you have some lenses, but you don't have the lenses that you have on a Micro Four Thirds system camera. Now I'm filming myself with Lumix G80. I use this camera on manual focus. With Fujifilm, maybe with X-T4, you can use it with eye tracking. But if you really want to do vlogs or want to do some videography, I must advise you to use X-T4. That I really think that camera, it is the only camera that can really deliver you the part of the videography that you want to do, or look at another system like Sony APS-C or Sony Full Frame. So on the videography part, the only camera from the Fujifilm system that I think it will deliver some good videography, it is the X-T4 and also the XS10. But you will have few lenses that will be able to really help you there. On a Micro Four Thirds system, you'll have Lumix 10 to 25 millimeters f1.8. Excellent for all kinds of videography shooting that you want to do, and all kinds of lenses that you can adapt. And I feel that the Micro Four Thirds system with GH5, GH5S, it is a more versatile system than X-T4. It also depends on what you really need. For vlogs like this, as you can see, I can use my G80 and I have no problems with image quality. The next point that I want to address to the Micro Four Thirds users, it is regarding the printing of the files. So we will talk at the noise, how to get rid of that noise and how to obtain better image quality at the end of this video. But let's look at some printed images. I will roll some b-roll with these images. But what I can tell you, this is a pro grade paper. I printed this image using my Epson printer. The images are made with Lumix GX9 and Olympus 25mm f1.8, a lens that I love and hate. It is not as a pro level lens, but it is good. It delivers, but it could be better. So what I can tell you is that I get excellent details, excellent resolution, excellent micro contrast. The images are looking great, great, great. They are edited in Nick Silver, and what I can say, you have here excellent details. Excellent details. This image, it is made with Olympus 30mm macro lens, and the details are amazing. And this is another image that is also made with Olympus 30mm macro lens. Also amazing details, amazing tonality, amazing sharpness. So, for street photography portraits, I really have no complaints. The images, the pictures are really, really beautiful, and I have an entire catalog of images like that. So, great results on bad light, on low light, on cloudy days with a Micro Four Thirds camera. The next pictures that I want to show you are landscape images. So, as you can see, great color, great tones, great, great results on an A4 sheet of paper. So, this image, it was done with the Olympus zoom, not the Pro zoom, the 75-300 Olympus zoom. What a beautiful zoom. Well, you can get such a small zoom with good quality. If you know what you are doing in post-processing, you can get these great results and print them pretty big. You will not have problems printing at a larger scale. You will not have problems. Also, this image, I think it is made with the 12-100 f4 Pro Zoom. Amazing, amazing quality, amazing details, amazing color. And remember, I'm not using the latest and greatest G9 camera or OMD EM1 Mark II or 3. I'm using Lumix GX9. This is another image, also made with that zoom, in winter time. Great details, great color. And I want to also show you this picture made in a very bad lighting situation with that zoom tube, the 75-300 zoom. Excellent colors, excellent details, it is all excellent. So, regarding the printing quality of a Micro Four Thirds camera, you will not have problems if you are using an Epson printer and Epson paper or Agfa photo paper and so on. I've got good results with all kinds of printing papers that I've used. So now let's talk how you can bypass the Micro Four Thirds problems if you are not decided to go with Fujifilm. First of all, you must think at the lenses. You really need good pro-grade lenses. If you don't use pro-grade lenses, you will not get good image quality. There are some lenses that aren't resolving that sensor enough. So, with the problems of a small sensor in low light, if you don't have good optics and especially a pro grade lens, you will not get good results. You will not get it. You can get acceptable results, you can get good results with good light, but when you don't have good light, you will lose it. The image quality will suffer. So, to get good results, to get good image quality, and to not feel that noise, you need pro-grade lenses. Also, yes, you can use the f2.8 Pro zoom lenses from Olympus, but have in mind that f2.8, it isn't sufficient. It isn't sufficient. When it is darker outside, when it is down outside, you want at least at f1.8 lens. But the problem is that glass, it is not a pro-grade glass. So, my advice to you is go with f1.4 lenses and f1.2 lenses from Olympus. I know they are bigger, I get it. I don't like that too. So this is why I've chosen the 20mm f1.4 lens, because it is very, very small. And with this small zoom, I can cover the 19% of my photography. This I can use it with good light, and when I have bad light, I can use this lens. So one of the solutions, it is work with the light, not against the light. A Micro Four Thirds sensor, and not just a Micro Four Thirds sensor, but a special Micro Four Thirds sensor will offer you a penalty when you have bad light. So, use at f1.4 lens or an f1.8 lens when you have bad light. Find a pro grade lens. If you will use a pro grade lens and an f1.4 lens, you will be there. Also, on Fujifilm, to get good results in low light, I need to use an f1.4 lens. And also on a full frame camera. But on a full frame camera, this Sony camera, I can get away with an f1.8 lens or an f2 lens because the lens, it is helped by the sensor. But this is not the case. And also for an APS-C body, you really need a good lens. I feel when I don't have a good lens, a good optical lens, the limitation of an APS-C sensor. So the first advice, it is go with the pro lenses. And let us hope that the OM system and the Lumix system will give us more pro lenses and lenses with at least f1.4 aperture. If we have small lenses with this aperture or at least pro grade lenses with at least f1.8 aperture, we can really get good results regarding the noise, the color and so on. The next step is to use good software and good images profiles. My advice to you, it is buy Cobalt Profiles. I've made a video for Fujifilm about these profiles. And I've recently bought these profiles for my Lumix GX9 camera. Because I've said if I want to use this lens on this body, I need to get the most of the files. So, the Cobalt Profiles are such a beautiful profile. You can get any color that you want on your Micro Four Thirds camera. But it's not just about the color. It is about the tones and the grades. I feel that when you are using a Cobalt profile, you get more dynamic range. You get that noise hided by the gradation of the tones and the good colors that you get in that file. So I really advise you to use the Cobalt profiles for your camera. And if you are using Capture One, also you will get better quality, better details. And with that Cobalt profiles, you will not believe what camera you have. I use Adobe Lightroom and I'm sorry for that. I know Capture One, it is better, but Adobe Lightroom, it is faster for the moment. So, use Capture One if you are using it or Adobe Lightroom with Cobalt profiles. After that, apply a noise reduction software to your files. And also be attentive to use that IBIS. The movement of a person can be freezed at 1/60 of a second. And with this IBIS, you can shoot indoors or outdoors in low light with 1/60 of a second. So this is a huge deal. So these are my advices for you to get good image quality from your Micro Four Thirds system. In conclusion, what to choose between a Fujifilm system or a Micro Four Thirds system? It is hard to tell you because this depends just on you. But what I can tell you it is that if I know what I am doing, I can obtain the same results with a Micro Four Thirds camera, depending on the photography that I'm doing. For me personally, I like Fujifilm and the Micro Four system too. They have different looks, but this doesn't mean that this look, it is not as good as that look or as a full frame look. A full frame camera, a full frame sensor has that full frame look. An APS-C sensor has that APS-C look and a Micro Four Thirds sensor has that Micro Four Thirds look. If you are pairing a Micro Four Thirds sensor With a pro lens, you will get pro results. The results are really, really good. Indoors, you will need an f1.2 lens and good light if you want to obtain good results, and you'll obtain good results. Also, for Fujifilm, if you want to do even photography, you'll also need light. You need to use two cameras with an f1.4 lens. Also, you can do this with a full-frame camera. But on a full-frame camera, you can use an f2.8 lens, so you can use just one camera. But also, for that f2.8, you will need some light. So, better think on what kind of photography you are doing, what kind of lenses you are using, and better think what to choose that it is light for you. What I can tell you is that, personally, I really like the 4x3 format. It is a beautiful format. A more versatile and a more easily to use, a more humanistic format, because it is taller. I can get people with a 40mm lens, I can frame them better than I can frame them with a 40mm equivalent lens on Fujifilm or on a Sony camera. If it is just about image quality, and you want to have a small camera that it will offer you good image quality, then my advice to you, it is why not go to Sony A7C with a small Sigma zoom, an f2.8 zoom, or a Tamron ultra zoom. Also, if you want primes, small primes, you'll have on a Sony camera Sigma primes, excellent optically, and Samyang lenses that are also excellent and cheap to buy. So, I think if you want better image quality, you can go on a Sony full-frame system or a Canon full-frame system and so on. For me, if I would have to choose just two systems, I will choose a Micro Four Thirds system and a full-frame system for professional work. But for fun landscape, I will surely use a Micro Four Thirds system. If I will need to use just one system, that it is better to do all kinds of photography styles, then I will choose Fujifilm system, because Fujifilm has enough quality to do even photography with small f1.4 lenses, and it has enough texture and good image quality that it is helping me to get the pictures that I want if I want to do professional photography, like wedding photography. What I can tell you, it's that it is hard to make a decision. But take a look again at your Micro Four Thirds system. It is not a bad system. All you need it is good lenses, and now I see the OM system and the Olympus are getting there with good lenses. So this is huge again. A good pro small lens, it is something that will improve your Micro Four Thirds photography. A good color profile from Cobalt will make a big difference. All we need now for a Micro Four Thirds system, it is a better sensor. Yes, a backside illuminated sensor, or I don't know, make it better. And it will be hard to choose. Maybe you want to go with Fujifilm or a full-frame camera just because you love the depth of field, the shallower depth of field. Yes, if you want shallower depth of field, go with a full-frame camera or with Fujifilm. But also, at f1.4 and at f1.2 lens, optimized lens with feather bokeh, a beautiful, pleasing, out-of-focusing bokeh, you get something. You really get something. You get a unique look. So, it depends on your budget and on your photography style. My advice to you, it is enjoy your photography, subscribe to my channel, check the links from the description and from the comments, and be sure to enter on my blog site to check the notes that I've made for this video, to check the sample pictures, and also subscribe to my newsletter to receive a full POV on how I shoot X100V and X-Pro3 at a event. Thank you for watching this video, and tell me what you think. Talk to you soon. Bye bye.